Welcome back to my LVGA 101. We are learning to construct screens using LVGA 1x1. As you know, what we can do in an MCU environment is extremely limited, but this allows us to do a lot. You can have a screen configuration similar to a mobile application, and also you can have various screens depending on the project. Today, we will look at using LVGA's own screen keyboard. This is a layout created in the previous episode. This is a static screen because no events are connected. The goal is to enable the keyboard to come up and receive input from the user when the password text area is selected. Before going into the code, let's find out how to place the keyboard object. We want to add a keyboard. Where should the keyboard belong at this time? Should I put it on the screen we created in the previous episode? Let's assume you put a keyboard object on the first screen. Then it becomes dependent on the first screen. Maybe this is gonna be fine, but what if we need a second screen and we are going to use this keyboard on the second screen as well? When I need a keyboard on the second screen, should I create another keyboard object? Or should I borrow the keyboard object from the first screen and use it? Unfortunately, this may not be a good solution. Managing keyboard object is also difficult. Also, it is difficult because when you move the screen up and down, the position of the keyboard may also move. The most reasonable way is to use the keyboard as another sibling object. Not only does this allow you to use the keyboard on any screen, but it's also not bad for code structure perspective. Here's the code we worked on in the previous episode. First, let's create a keyboard object. As I said, create the keyboard at the same level as the screen, not inside the first screen. Also, since the keyboard does not need to come out from the beginning, we will hide it using a hidden flag. We will create a callback function for the password text area. This enters the focus state when the password input space is touched by your finger. At this time, not only the touched object, but also the connected keyboard object can be obtained from this callback function. You can find out the state of the event through the getCode function. Also, you can retrieve the object of the text area through the getTarget function. Additionally, the keyboard object will also be passed through the getUserData function, so you can refer to the keyboard object through this. Now you have all the objects you need, so you just need to define the actions to take when the text area is focused and defocused. Just remove and add the hidden flag so that the keyboard appears on the screen and is hidden. Now let's go to the user password and register the callback function we just created. Since it is set to event all, the callback function is executed whenever all events occur. Also, since the keyboard is set as the last parameter, user data becomes the keyboard object, so we can use this from the callback function. Oh, almost forgot it. Since the text color is not specified in the text area's style, we will set it to white. Now wherever we touch this password text area, the keyboard will appear so it can receive user input. Also, if you touch anywhere else on the screen, the keyboard disappears again because it loses focus. This was implemented as we wanted. But there is one problem. If the keyboard appears right away, it covers up the text area so you can check your entered keys. This is very unfriendly and fatal to user experience. We need to move the screen when the keyboard appears so that the user can check what they have entered. Moving it with an animation effect can be more effective than just moving it. As the screen moves vertically, we will change the values on the y-axis. The object actually moves through this animycb callback function. Next, let's implement the parts needed for animation. You can set all the desired effects by creating a variable of the type lvanim. This is very similar to how we style lv objects. We will make the screen object a global variable so that it can be easily accessed from other functions. Go to the AnimScreen function again and specify the target for animation as the screen. Now let's set up different animation behaviors depending on whether the screen goes up or down. If the touch starts, the screen must be up. At this time, you can set the speed of the animation by specifying the length of the animation. The shorter the length, the faster the animation will end. We will also move up the screen about 100 pixels along the y-axis. Then we will be able to see the password input area. You can set the animation path. This is like the animation curve, which tells you what style the animation will move on. Set the same in the opposite case. When the user input ends and the keyboard disappears, the screen should move back to the original position. In this case, I set the animation length to 100 milliseconds to make it run faster. It also moves to zero, the original position of the screen's y-axis. The animation path was set to lvanimPathEasin. Before starting the animation, set up callback function that actually moves the screen object and runs it to start the animation. Going back to the text area callback function, when focused, it calls AnimScreen true, otherwise it calls AnimScreen false. Now let's build again and check. Whenever you try to type on the keyboard, the screen moves up so you can see what you are typing without it being covered by the keyboard. It also seems to work much better because it moves smoothly across the screen thanks to the animation effect. It now works the way I wanted, and I'm happy that I was able to implement everything I wanted to show in this episode. Lastly, if the password is a type that requires entering numbers, you can select your desired input method through the keyboard set mode function. With these settings, entering numbers is the default. Depending on the input type, you can set the keyboard style you want. This is an extra example I made in the same style. Also, you can download and check the source code from my GitHub. When using TFT API in LVGL, it has a screen rotation setting, and when entering a password, it turns into an asterisk to hide your password on the screen. Other than that, it's the same. It's really fun to be able to configure the screen you want. Also, I'm curious to see how far it can go in the MCU environment. Okay, that's it. I will think of a more interesting episode. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.